Good evening. Welcome to worship on Christmas Eve. We're thrilled that you are here to celebrate the birth of Christ. A few simple announcements. First announcement, we have a few more people coming in, and Casey, I see you back there, and maybe Nate, can you bring a few more chairs up from the downstairs for the people to sit in the back? Oh. Tonight's service will be a service without a sermon, mainly songs and scriptures and candles and a story entitled Christmas Dinner at Mary's Place, written by a pastor in Wilmington, Delaware. There is no offering taken up tonight, but for those who insist, we always put a plate in the back. Holy Communion tonight is for all who put their trust in Jesus Christ and their children. All are welcome to partake of this holy feast. And if there are those who are at home participating in the service, you can prepare elements, juice and bread. And when we take communion here, I will consecrate all the communion that folks are taking online so that we can eat and drink together. Next Sunday, the Christmas program at Sharpsburg, followed by a brunch, 9 a.m. for the program, brunch at 10. Here at the Lenox Church, there will be a baptismal service. Come on out on New Year's Eve to worship. We begin tonight with a thank you for our decorations committee for this beautiful sanctuary. With Christy's help, we'd like to read aloud the memory of and the in honor of for our 2023 Christmas poinsettias. In memory of Eldon Bowes by Nancy Bowes.
In memory of Tom Lynham and Aaron Byerly by Denise Lynham and Elizabeth.
In memory of Mom and Dad by Sherry Seaton, Jenny Tyler, and Rick Tyler.
In memory of Mia Mays, Harold and Gwen Mays by Lyle and Bobby Mays.
In memory of the deceased family members by Mark and Lori Hoffman.
In memory of Joy Miller by Mike and Gentry Miller.
In memory of Donna Tillman by Mike and Gentry Miller.
In memory of Mia Mays by Mike and Gentry Miller.
In memory of Tom Lynham and Alan Dukes by Ramona Parman.
In memory of Harry Freeman by Darlene Freeman.
In honor of Diva Lundquist and Vivian Strait by Darlene Freeman.
In celebration of Meg Sherwood by Kylie Sherwood Pollard.
In celebration of our Savior's birth by John and Rita Barron.
In memory of John Donaldson by Sandra Donaldson and Craig and Becky Donaldson.
In memory of Don and Betty Donaldson, by Sandra Donaldson and Craig and Becky Donaldson. And now let us worship God. Reader and candlelighter, come.
Isaiah says, the root of Jesse shall come, the one who rises to rule the Gentiles. In him the Gentiles shall hope. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace and believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. The candle of hope.
Our first piece of special music tonight, Becky Donaldson on piano, Sandy Maxa on flute, Some Children See Him, and Ave Maria. Thank you.
printed in your bulletins. We have walked too long in the darkness of our sins.
Send Christ into our lives to lead us into the light.
Forgive our sins and cleanse us from unrighteousness.
Assure us that Christ is Emmanuel, God with us.
For without your presence, O God, we cannot live.
But in you, O God, we find light, life, and peace.
Hear the words of the resurrected Christ from John 20.
Brothers and sisters, I declare to you the truth in Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven.
The candle of peace.
Remain seated for our congregational hymn. It's 124, Still, Still, Still. Sharpsburg choir.
from Luke chapter 2, verses 15 through 20. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and they saw the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. The candle of love.
Let us stand together as we sing hymn number 100, O Come, All Ye Faithful. Emily. Bless us.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
He was in the beginning with God. I received a text at 6:45. From a father grieving the death of his son this year. And he said to me, I just can't do it. Knowing that he is not alone, we have a minute for mission entitled Love at Christmas from the Presbyterian Mission Yearbook. Luis was a tiny, helpless infant born to a young mother in Brazil, abandoned out of poverty at 2 months of age. His new parents became Peter and Maria, mission co-workers in Brazil. Malnourished and ill when they got him, Luis is now healthy, energetic, ready to engage the world. Even at such a young age, Luis has taught his new family many things about love. Countless children like Luis are born into harsh circumstances in Brazil and around the world. Many of them experience God's love through mission efforts. Many more are waiting to be reached with the gospel. God's greatest gift of love, a new life, was given to the world 2,000 years ago. Jesus, Emmanuel, a tiny, helpless infant born to a young woman in a crude stable. He came into a world that was malnourished from evil and hatred, from such simple and harsh circumstances at birth. Jesus would go on to demonstrate to us the depth of God's love for us and all humankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness will not overcome it. The Christ candle. Remain seated and turn, if you will, to hymn number 130, Infant Holy, Infant Lowly. Remain seated as we sing together both verses.
Grace, come on. You you are moving too slow. We have to get home. How far is many dinner?
I'm coming, but look. Grace had stopped to focus on a doll named Sage in the toy store window. Just look at her dress and cowgirl boots, Dad. You know Sage is on my list for Christmas, right? Mateo knew everything on Grace's list, but he tried to get her mind off the presents by saying,
look, we have to wait and see what Santa brings.
Mateo looked at Grace to see what she was thinking. He wasn't about to say anything to spoil Grace's hopes, but Jeff had been out of work for 3 months this past year, and Mateo knew that he and Grace shouldn't expect too much from Santa, Dad, or Papa. Nevertheless, Sage was on Grace's list, and she would be in a special wrapped box in the morning.
Come on. Time to go home, kids.
Grace took Jeff's hand again while keeping her eyes fixed on the window. By the time Jeff and the kids made it to their apartment building, they could see the Christmas tree in the window on the second floor. It had been a family project to decorate the tree with crimsons, paper stars and crosses and angels in white and gold. And there were twinkling lights and homemade strings of popcorn, each one a nursery school creation that Mateo and Grace had made just a few years before. They were carefully packed away each year for the tree that was always in the window. This year, Grace had made a special angel of paper mache and placed her with the angel to keep an eye on all that was happening below. As they climbed the stairs to their building, Mateo paused to say hi to Mary.
Hi.
The homeless woman, who had gathered all her worldly possessions of plastic bags and scraps of food and pieces of paper into the cart that she had taken from the grocery store on permanent loan. With everything jammed into the cart, she camped on the building steps because no one seemed to come or go from the vacant store next door. Mary could wrap up for the night and sleep there undisturbed. Grace and Mateo had made a point of befriending Mary. They stopped to talk sometimes and called her by her name. What's up, Mary? Grace said, not sure whether Mary would answer or not. Sometimes she did, and sometimes she didn't. Mary had wrapped herself in wool for the night, two coats around her, and a double blanket over her shoulders. She looked up and saw Grace's friendly face.
Hello, Gracie. How are you doing?
Good. It's going to be cold tonight.
Yes, almost freezing.
And with that, Mary reached inside her blanket to the folds of clothing beneath.
I got you something for all four of you.
She pulled out a card and an envelope addressed with a scrawl that looked a little shaky. All four names were there, Miguel and Jeff, Grace and Mateo. Grace opened the envelope, and there on the card was a drawing of a manger in Bethlehem, with Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus, the wise men and shepherds, and all the animals gathered around the Holy Family. Inside the card were the words, A Blessed Christmas from Mary.
Thanks, Mary.
Grace said while holding the card up for all to see.
Well, it's going to be a good Christmas Eve for all. Have a good Christmas, Mary.
Thanks.
Therefore, Mary said as she pulled the blanket a little closer around her. By the time Jeff and the children were in the apartment, it was time for dinner. The girls had prepared a beautiful centerpiece with fresh cut greens on the fireplace mantel, a poinsettia plant, and a large red candle burning brightly. The tree was placed in front of the window, shining and bright, and Grace's angel was reigning over it all. Some music on the CD player gave the room a Christmas feeling, and a warm atmosphere of togetherness filled the room. The smell of the soup made Mateo's hungry stomach growl like a lion. The kids and dads all sat at the table and joined hands for a prayer.
Thank God for this special night. Thank you for our family and bless all the people who are hungry and lonely and need help tonight. Amen.
They all squeezed hands, and then there was a long pause after the prayer. Something wasn't right about the meal. Something Jeff had said in his prayer made them all think of what it is to have a Merry Christmas with family and food and thoughts of those who have no family.
I have an idea. Papa worked so hard to have this special Christmas dinner, but I'm wondering if there isn't someone missing. I'm thinking about Mary. thinking about her being outside on the steps while we're in here having dinner. I think we might need to share what we have, not only the great food, but our family. We can be Mary's family tonight because family can be everyone you want to include.
Grace and Mateo immediately liked the idea. Let's invite her in, they said together. They all agreed this sounded like a good idea. Jeff went downstairs to get Mary and bring her inside. Then he was back in a flash, saying,
she won't come up. I told her we wanted her to join us for dinner, but Mary said she didn't want to leave her things downstairs.
Someone would steal my stuff.
Well, we tried.
Not hard enough. If she won't come inside, let's go outside. It was as if the idea came like the twinkling of one of the lights on the tree. All at once, they knew what they would do. Everyone started picking up plates and napkins, forks and spoons. They took the table setting, the cut greens and candle, and they all went down the stairs to the place where Mary was bundled in coats and blankets. What are you doing?
It's Christmas Eve, and everybody needs to have a family tonight. You're part of our family, so if you won't come to us, we'll come to you.
Mary knew not to argue with Grace. Soon they had dinner spread on the steps. With each new course, they took turns, picking up a stack of dishes and taking them inside, then bringing down the next course and the next, all the way to the Unuelos. After they ate, they sang a few carols on the steps, O Little Town of Bethlehem, and Silent Night, though Mary wasn't much of a singer. Before long, it was time to say goodnight, since Mary was already nodding off. Her tummy filled for once with good food. It was time to go upstairs and settle in for the night. As Grace stood up from her step next to Mary, she said,
Sweet dreams, Mary.
But Mary was already asleep. Later, when Jeff tucked Grace into bed, she looked at Jeff and asked, Dad, Mary isn't really a member of our family, is she? Jeff thought for a moment, but before he could say anything, Grace looked at him and said, It doesn't make any difference. I like that she's part of our family.
We're all part of God's family, because family is anyone you want to include. That's what God did at Christmas, became one of us in Jesus, and included all of us in God's family. Now, go to sleep, Grace. It's already a blessed Christmas. Our congregational hymn, the first two verses of 123, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, 123. with the elders from Lenox and Sharpsburg, to whom I've spoken, come on up for the serving of Holy Communion. Please.
Thank you.
Elders, come forward.
Thank you.
come and serve the Lord this day and forevermore. Amen.